The Sons of Horus fought in every major theatre of the Horus Heresy. Already fiercely loyal and proud of their War Master, they had no hesitation turning upon their brothers loyal to the Golden Throne. Hello and welcome to this Horus Heresy painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint a Legionnaire in the colours of the Sons of Horus. However, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply it to any model in your collection. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, let's get started. Now before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect for the colours we're going to be applying in this video. Now the first area we're going to concentrate on is the power armour. And for this we'll be using Sons of Horus Green as our first colour. So what I'm going to do is just get that onto the palette. A couple of dollops, like so. I'm using my medium base brush here as well. And all I'm going to do is add a little bit of water just so it's not too thick and goopy. And then the next thing is to start applying that over the armour. Now this is a layer paint, but it's perfect, especially when going over Mechanica Standard Grey, as you'll only need to do a couple of coats of this. So work your way around and just apply a second coat if you need to. With the armour now base coated, what we're now going to do is move on to applying a contrast. Now for this we'll be using Pterodon Turquoise. I'm going to heavily thin this down with contrast medium. We're looking at 5 parts contrast medium to 1 part Pterodon Turquoise. So what I'm going to do is get a medium shade brush and get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts of contrast. Give it a quick wash and a dry of the old brush, and then 1 part Pterodon Turquoise, like so, and then mix together. This is quite thin, which is fine. What we're now going to do is heavily apply that to the armour. Now the great thing here is most of that will run into those recesses and just ever so slightly change the tint of that armour in preparation for the next stages. Obviously be mindful of this pooling, and if you do find it pooling near the bottom, just use your brush and soak it up. With that Pterodon Turquoise and contrast medium mix now dry, what we're now going to do is move on to highlighting the armour. Now I'm going to start first with Sons of Horus Green. What we're going to do here is do a heavy dry brush just to get rid of some of those streaks on some of those flat panels and just bring out that colour a little bit more. Then we'll finish off with a final highlight of a dry brush of Saberite Green. But first of all, let's start with the Sons of Horus. I'm just going to lay my brush up. Don't need too much on the brush. I'm just going to do some circular motions and crisscross motions. What we're aiming to do here is just remove most of that pigment from the bristles, still leaving traces. And then all I'm going to do now is then just start dry brushing over that armour. Now what you're aiming to do here is pick out those raised areas, but still leave that colour in the recesses. When you get to things like the actual power armour flat panel, such as the shoulder pad, you just want to put a little bit more pressure on there, just so you get rid of some of those streaky effects. You might want to do this a couple of times just to bring out the colour. This is quite a messy job, so we're doing it at the start because we don't want to get like colours on the gun, so don't worry about that, we'll paint that later. With that first heavy dry brush applied, what we're now going to do is get Saberite Green, and we're just going to do a nice soft dry brush across the armour, just picking out those edges. You can take your time, work your way around. There we are, with that dry brushing now done, our armour is finished. So what we're now going to do is move on to picking out some other details. We're going to start first with Black Templars, just for the black details, such as the gun casing, as well as those joints in the armour. After that, we'll be using Iron Hand Steel for the silver details, Balthazar Gold for any bronze details. Then we'll pick out the lenses using Mephiston Red, and then we're just going to coat over those metallics using Basilicarnum Grey. But first of all, let's start with that Black Templar. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit out of the pot. I'm using it straight from the pot, but I'm just using my palette here so I can get a nice point to my brush. Then all I'm going to do is then coat that over the actual gun casing itself. Don't matter if you get it on the areas, it will be silver because we'll be painting over those in a bit anyway. And also I'll be using it on those joins in the armour. So if I just spin around, so what I'm going to do is just coat this straight over. Now I know we've obviously got some Sons of Horus there, but it's fine, because once it's dry, it'll look nicely highlighted. Just take your time, work your way around. Now that we've applied the Black Templar, what we're now going to do is move on to Iron Hand Steel. Most of this is going to go on the bolt gun, but there's a few details on his backpack to do as well. Now that we've picked out the silver areas, what we're now going to do is pick out those brass areas. For this, we're using Balthazar Gold. So I'm going to do these molecular bonding studs on his shoulder pad, and there's also just these little vents at the top there. And take your time. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy up with those previous colours. Now that we've picked out the brass details, we're going to move on to those eye lenses. Now we're using Mephiston Red here. Take your time, try and get your brush to a nice point, and then just do some little slits like so. I'm just going to roll that brush again to get a nice point to it again, and just do the other eye as well. Now that we've picked out the lenses, we're going to coat over those metallics using basilicarnum grey. I'm also going to just run that over that gun casing as well. Now that our basilicarnum grey is thoroughly dry, what we're now going to do is move on to highlighting the model. We're going to start first by using Dawnstone. We're going to be dry brushing this over some black details. After that, we're going to be using Stormhost Silver for the metallics, and then a little bit of Wild Rider Red just to pick some definition out in those eye lenses. But first of all, let's start with our dry brush. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit of Dawnstone, and I'm just going to do some circular motions, crisscross motions, help remove as much of that pigment as possible, and then we're ready to start applying that. So this is mainly going to be on the gun casing, but also a little bit on that strap as well. So all I'm going to do is just do like some little flicks up and down just to pick out a little bit of definition. Don't worry if you get some grey on some of that silver, because we'll be highlighting over those details anyway. With that dry brush complete, we're now going to finish off some of the edges of the metallics using a little bit of Stormhost Silver. I'm just using the edge of my brush here, not going too mad. Now that we've highlighted with Stormhost Silver, we're going to get a little bit of Wild Rider Red and just add a little bit more punch to those lenses. So I'm just going to start on there with a little dot on that one, and I'm just going to do a little line on the eyes. If you do make any mistakes like I've just done here, like getting some on the actual helmet, you can just tidy back up with some of the previous colours. With those highlights now done, what we're now going to do is move on to basing the model. Now we're going to start first by using Black Templar. This is in preparation for our next paint, which is going to be Aghrim Badland, because as that cracks, you want to see grey or green under there. Then after that, we're going to get some basilicarnum grey, slightly thin it down with a little bit of contrast medium, and then apply that all over. But first of all, let's start off with the Black Templar. So I'm going to be using this straight from the pot. So I'm just going to load up my brush, and then all I'm going to do is then just start painting that onto the base like so. Just need to go in there and get some more. Take your time. Be mindful when you get close to the feet, so just be a bit careful about that. And you only need one coat of this, because all we're trying to do is just darken down that base a bit. Now that we've applied Black Templar to the base, what we're now going to do is get Aghrim Badlands, and we're then going to start coating that over. So I'm just starting off with the large side of the texture tool first, get that placed on, and I'm going to move to the smaller side for a little bit more accuracy. And again, just be mindful when you get close to those feet. With our texture now dry, all I'm going to do now is get some basilicarnum grey and apply that all over. Now I've thinned this down with two parts contrast medium to one part basilicarnum grey, just so it's not too neat. Just working my way around, applying it like so. With the base now done, all that's left to do is paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your army. As you can see here, I've used Steel Legion Drab. With our model and base finished, our Sons of Horus Legionnaire is ready to eradicate anyone that stands against their beloved Warmaster. Now there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. If you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point. Also, when using shades or contrast, try not to overload your brush, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Sons of Horus, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.